Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a lip sync animation in PowerPoint. It's really easy to make if you just follow these simple steps. So what we're actually trying to do is get all of the pieces of a mouth animation together, animate them in PowerPoint, export them as either a video or an animated GIF, and then bring it back into the PowerPoint slide. Slap that animation onto a character into your PowerPoint slide so that when you start talking, it looks like the character is talking, and when you stop talking, it'll look like the characters stop talking. So first of all, you want to get your images for your mouth animation. I've used this website. You can use plenty of others. You can get them free or you can buy them. I've bought these ones, but you can also download animated GIFs that are already made, but for copyright reasons I didn't do that, and I also think making your own video is better. So first of all, I'm going to crop each of those sections of the animation out of this image. So there's a bit of a nifty way of doing it. Use the crop tool, make sure that you've got a crop window, and then duplicate the slide and then just slide the cropping along to each mouth animation. It's also very useful to have the exact same size of mouth when you're animating them. So this is a great way of doing it. So once you've got all of your mouths together, you want to stack them on top of each other perfectly. So to do that, you go on the arrange tool and you want them to be arranged to middle and then arranged to center, or aligned to center. And now they are perfectly on top of one another. And now to animate, click all of them together and click on appear on the animation screen. And then to make it of a longer animation, click all of them and click duplicate, which is Control D on the shortcut keys. And then you'll have twice as many animations. Now you can see those animations are all gonna happen at once. So you want them to be slightly staggered. So click on animate one after another, and have a time frame of 0.2 seconds or 0.15, whatever you want. Depends on how fast the animation you want it to be. And then you need to save it as a video or an animated GIF. Video is better, I believe, for when you're animating the lip sync, but you can choose. So save as an MPEG video. We need to import that video back into our slide along with the character we're going to be using. You can make your own character, it's up to you. But I've been lazy and I've downloaded them from another website. It's also going to make it look more professional if you keep things consistent with the characters you use. Automatically, when you import a video, you get these animations play and stop on click. We'll probably delete those. You also need to use the trim section so that you can definitely see the mouth when you start when the animation starts, when the video starts. And you want to trim off the end of the video so that it stops on a mouth. Sometimes you get dead air at the end. Now crop it really small so it's just small enough to fit onto your character. And firstly, I'm just going to show you how to make your own character. So you make an auto shape. Make a circle, send it to back so it's behind the video, and then add some eyes using the auto shapes. This is an easy way of doing it and a lazy way of doing it, and a cost-effective way of doing it, but it's just to show you how it can be done. And the other thing I want to show you is playing with colours, because not all of your characters are going to be white, but this video that I've made has a white background, and you need to consider that. So what you can see here is I'm changing the color of the video using the format tool. If I do that, I need to make sure I also do that to the skin color of the character I've made. Now in a minute, I'm going to show you how to do it with a more professional looking character. But it just shows you that it can be done by using the eyedropper tool. So you click on one of the colors, and then when you're trying to color the other things, such as the skin, use the eyedropper tool and move over to the video and just take the color from that. at the moment you can see the voice, the mouth is just constantly talking, which is great, the animation works, but later on we're gonna need it to start and stop at the time of when you're talking. So here is the animation and here is the character. So what you can do instead of saving that video with a white background is using the eyedropper tool and setting the background of your slide to the same skin color as your character. And then when you save that animation, you're already gonna have the skin color of the character you're gonna be using. So it's planning ahead when you're animating things. But the alternative is if you just save it with a white background, and then you can use that same mouth every time you use a different character, just by using the by using color select. So here it is, I've got the animation of the video and I just need to crop it down, trim off the edges. I also want to make sure on the playback section that I always click loop play until next click. Otherwise it'll only play once and it'll just stop. I've also on this, just to make it blend well with the character, I'm using the blur tool, blur edges or soft edges, and then it makes it less of a definite line around the edge of it. So now you need to create your own audio. So let's say you've got a slide and you're talking about something that you're selling or something that you're making or teaching something. You rehearse it all into this recorded section and then the PowerPoint will automatically save it as a audio file within the PowerPoint. So actually I'm just recording dead air at the moment, but it's to show you how this will work. So once you've recorded yourself, you click OK, and you'll have this little audio icon and a little playback section underneath it. And what we're going to do is set certain bookmarks on the audio. So every time I start talking, I'll set a bookmark, and every time I stop talking, even if it's just for a moment, I'm going to set another bookmark. So at the end of this audio, I'll have 5 or 6 bookmarks. So you click on the audio. Oh, I'm also going to make sure that the slide only moves on when I want it to, rather than every time I click something. It's also a really good idea when you're setting up your slideshow, make sure that you make all the media controls disappear. Okay, so adding some bookmarks. So click on play until the voice starts talking, click add a bookmark. When he stops talking, add another bookmark. It'll all make sense in the end. If it hasn't already, it'll all make sense in a minute. Okay. So now I'm going to go on the animation section with the video, and I want it to play, but on the set, I want it to play when I start the first bookmark. So the audio will play. When it reaches the first bookmark, the voice will start talking, the mouth will start talking. When it reaches the second bookmark, it will pause. If you want to animate one thing several times, you have to click on add animation, otherwise it won't work. So you click add animation, click on pause, and then go on timing on effect options and move to start on the certain bookmark where you want it to correspond to. And you do that over and over and over again in your animation pane until you've got a start and stop, start and stop, start and stop. And make sure all of them happen with previous, otherwise it'll only ever happen when you click a button, and that's not going to work. The audio, however, keep that it only starts on click, and then when you open your slideshow, you're in control of when that audio begins, and then you're more in control of when and the video will start, or the mouth will start moving. So start with previous, and click on the top, go on the slideshow, and let's have a go. Okay, so as you can see, the chap is talking and stopping, talking and stopping. It's dead air, but the concept works, and as you can see at the beginning of this video, I made it work. And you can too, if you follow these steps. One extra thing, this is a bit of a, I always hate these icons of the audio. So I've gone on replace image and replaced it with my logo. And I've also moved it to his shirt, so it looks like it's an emblem on his shirt. So that then when I click on slideshow, if I click on his shirt, that's when the audio will start and that's when the video will start. I hope this video has been useful to you. And if you think this has been useful to you, then subscribe and I'll see you in the next video.